we have some steps. If you follow these steps, then easily we can do that. So first, here today, we are going to design a mode 6 synchronous counter using JK flip-flop. Keep in your mind, I'm going to design a mode 6 counter, synchronous counter I'm going to use with the help of JK flip-flop. But they're not mention number of bits and they're not mention number of flip-flop you're going to use. Then how to design? This is the first question that arises in our mind. What is the first step you need to do? So find the number of flip-flops required to build the counter. This is my first question. So find the number of flip-flops required for the required to build the counter. Then how to find? So in order to do this process, I'll give a small formula. Just use this. You can see that flip-flops required, flip-flop requires are is equal to 2 to the means it is 2 to the power of n should be it is greater than or equal to capital N. Here n indicates number of modes and small n indicates number of flip-flop it's required. Okay, so I'm going to use this formula. For example, I have a condition, it is I make my n value it is 1. Okay, I'm going to, is it possible to construct from one flip-flop? Let's check it out. So 2 to the power of 1 should be greater than or equal to capital N. N value they are given mode 6. So 6 is a, you need to consider here it is 6. 2 to the power of 2, 1 is nothing but 2. 2 it is greater than or equal to 6. No, this condition it is not possible. Then it is not possible from the one flip-flop. Then I'll go for N value it is 2. Okay, I'll take N value it is 2. It is checking for this condition. So 2 to the power of 2 is nothing but 4. 4 it is not equal or greater than equal to 6. Then this condition also it is not satisfied. Then what is the other option I have? 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 is nothing but greater than or equal to 6. Yeah, 2 to the power of 3 is nothing but 8. 8 is definitely greater than or equal to 6. Then I'm going to use. So n number of flip-flops, nothing but 3 flip-flops I need to use to construct the circuit. If it is a mode 6 counter. Is it clear? First step, finding the number of flip-flops. Okay. So maybe if it is a 3 flip-flop I can use, but you already know that if it is a 3 flip-flop means it is 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 is nothing but 8. It will count from 0 to 7. But they are telling it's a mode 6 counter. I don't want 0 to 7. Mode 6 means I need to count 0 to 5. Totally it will come to 6 counts. I want to stop at the 5. After 5, I want to repeat the process. It will come back to 0 and this process it will be repeated. That is my intention. Then how to construct this one? This is very important. So that is an important thing we'll consider here. Let's see how we are going to do that. Second step, this is the first step what I'm getting. That's what I'm telling. If you take on a binary counter, it will count from 0 to 7. After 7, it will come back. I don't want this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means it is 1, 0, 1. After 1, 0, 1, I don't want to go here. It is, I want to come back to 0. That is my intention. That is called, it's a mode 6 counter they're going to use. I want only 6 modes. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, it will come back to 0 only. Then how to construct? Let's see on that. So once you got this idea, number of flip-flop, let's move on to the second step. Write the excitation table of our JK flip-flop. Here I'm going to use JK flip-flop for my construction. That's why you need to write the excitation table of JK flip-flop. So please write down this. So JK flip-flop excitation table. So then only easily you can build the circuit or build the table. So please write down this. Qn, Qn plus 1, J and K. So suppose if they are asking to design using SR flip-flop means you need to consider SR flip-flop excitation table. Or D flip-flop means you need to write the D flip-flop. T flip-flop means you need to write the T flip-flop. So here Qn indicates present state. Qn plus 1, it indicates the next state. This is my present state and this is the next state. What is the meaning of excitation table? Excitation table, it will predict what is the input for a given output. Okay, so here it is, the inputs are J and K. Easily we can predict from the present state and the next state. Suppose my present state it is 0, next state also 0 means jk values it is 0x. 0, 1 is there 1x. 1, 0 is there x1. 1, 1 is there x0. If you know this excitation table, then directly I'll go for one more step, that is step number 3. Write determine transition table. Step 3, determine transition table. Okay, so how to write this table? That's very important thing, and this is almost same process of your flip-flop conversion. So what we studied of flip-flop conversion, this one almost the same thing only. Just see what I need to do. I already told that I'm going to use a 3 flip-flop. Yes, because of synchronous counter, I'm going to use a 3 flip-flops. I'm going to use. Yes, next, because of synchronous counter means what I'm telling. So I need to consider my clock signals. Just see, I'm going to use the 3 clocks now. This is one clock. This is another clock. This is another clock. I'm going to connect it. Here it is, clock. Okay. And I'm going to use a JK flip-flop. Yeah, I'm going to connect it JK. And Q, I have a QA here. And QA bar here. This is the present state. Next state value here it is. QA plus 1 I'm going to take here. QA plus 1. Remember, it is JA, KA. Here it is, JA and KA are the inputs. QA and QA bar are the present states. QA1 plus and QA1 plus bar are taken as a next state. Okay. Similarly, here it also JB, KB and similarly QB, QB plus you can consider. Similarly, JC, KC you need to consider for this. So this is a circuit I need to design. My intention it is, what is the inputs? JA, KA, how I'm going to connect? Similarly, JB, KB, how I'm going to connect? JC, KC, how I'm going to connect? These values only I'm going to predict it here from this table. Okay, so then you write this table. I'm going to tell here it is 3 flip-flop I'm going to use. Here it is, outputs are QA, QB and QC. This is the present state outputs. And next state outputs I'm going to take as QA plus 1, QB plus 1 and QC plus 1. With the help of these two, I can predict my flip-flop inputs. What are the flip-flops input you have? JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. Clear? So remember, you need to write this table. Here, present states are QA, QB, QC. Next states are QA plus 1, QB plus 1, QC plus 1. And by the help of these two, I can predict the values of JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. Now, I need to fill this table. How I'm going to fill? Carefully, you see that it is a 3-bit counter. 3-bit counter means I'll get some count from 0 to 7. Yes, I have a decimal number of 0 to 7. Suppose if 0 to 7 is there, what is the next values I need to predict? So I already told that my counts are here, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, after 5, because it's a mode 6 counter. It will count from 0 to 5. So it will come back to, once it is 5, the next value here it is, it will come back to 0. That is my process. That is the thing I need to do. Okay. So you just tell me, I'm going to take in a 3 flip-flop, how I'm going to represent it 0 in terms of binary. What is 0? How I'm going to represent in binary in terms of 3 bits? Yeah. 0, 0, 0. You just carefully observe that. If my present state it is 0, what is my next state? I have a count now, it is 0. What is the next count? What is the next count? Carefully you see here. 1 only, right? 1 means how I'm going to represent it in binary? Yeah. So here, carefully, QA1 plus value it is 0, 0, 1. Clear? If present state it is 0, 0, 0, next state value it is 0, 0, 1. Now, similarly, you try for the next condition. Suppose my present state value it is 0, 0, 1. Now, what is the next state value? If present state it is 1, what is the next state? How I'm going to represent? Yeah. So you need to write carefully, see that 0, 1, 0. Next, again you fill the table. 0, 1, 0 is there, my present state. What is my next state? Yeah, right here it is. 0, 1, 1. Now, if 0, 1, 1 is there, what is the next value? Yeah, 3 means next value, it become, it is 4, 1, 0, 0. Okay, I'll take 1, 0, 0, 4. Yeah, directly I can take 1 0 1 1 0 0 is there, next value it is 101. Next 101 is there, what is the next value? See, after 5 you can't write 6. According to this they are telling it's a mode 5 counter. After 5 you need to come back to 0, that is my intention. Okay, then next state it is 0 0 0. Carefully you see that this is a small changes. So if my value it is 5, the next state value here it is 0 0 0. Okay, suppose my state, because it's my counter, 3-bit counter, it will start to count from 0 to 7. My values are 6 is there. 6, how I'm going to represent? 100 is there, 110 is there. What is the next state value? I'm not going to use a 6th state, but it's a counter. Counter, definitely this condition will come to an existence. That time, what you have to do, I'm not going to consider this state. So the next state value, we can't predict this one. Then we are going to take it as x, x, x. Means don't care conditions. Similarly, my 7th value also it is 1, 1, 1. This state also I'm not going to consider. We are going to make it as x, x, x. Clear about this one? How we are going to fill present state and next states? Okay, once it is clear, then what is the next task? I want to predict my JA and KA, JB and KB. And you are all expert. You already done flip-flop conversions, right? Excitation table, same process only. So I'm going to use excitation table of JK flip-flop. You can see I'm going to use this. By using this, I can predict the values of JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. Carefully you see that. So here I'm going to use QA and QA1 plus. QA, it is my present state. And QA1 plus, it is my next state value. I can predict the value of JA and KA. You just see QN present state, QN plus 1 next state. Then easily I can predict values JK, J and K, right? Similarly, you just tell me what is the value you will get for J and K. If the values are 0 and here also 0. If both the values are 0, 0, what is J and K? 0, X. Clear? Similarly, you just tell me the next value. Yeah, you just fill the table. 0, X is there. Next value it is 0, X. Okay. Next value 0x, okay. Yeah, see that 0 and 1 is there. 0, 1 means I'll get 1x. Good. Yeah, 1x. Next, 1, 1 is there. Yeah, we'll go for x0. Carefully, you see that I have 1, 1, then it is x0. Similarly, 1, 0. X1. Next. Next, what I need to do? I have a 1 and x. If it is there, simply you just put a xx. Don't worry. So entire thing, so entire this row, it will come all x's only. This x's. Because I'm not going to use these states. I'm bothered about only 0 to 5. Clear about this one? Similarly, just fill JB and KB with the help of QB as well as QB plus 1. So just fill this table. JB, KB and JC, KC. I'll give you 2 minutes of job for time. Okay, just tell me JB and KB, first value. Yeah, what is the value? Yeah, next value you can see that I'll get x and 1. So just see that our values here, it is 1 is there and next it is a 0, 1, 0. I'm okay. Yeah, I can see that I have a 1, next value it is 1 and here it is 0 is there, 1, 0 condition I'll get x1 just by x1. Similarly, just fill next value 0x. Next value 0x. What is the next value? Yeah, just xx and xx, just fill that. Similarly, just tell me for JC and KC. Good. Next. Okay. Good. Okay. Next, just fill the values of xx. Just, you just take the present state, next state and write the predict these values and remaining if not there means you just fill the values of x's. Is it clear this step? Is it clear? Okay. So once it is clear, then use a K-map to simplify because I want to predict the circuit. What is my input? My JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. You need to use a K-maps. With the help of K-map, you can find out the value of JA, KA, JB, KB, JC, KC. Okay, let's move on to that. You can try that. So this is my final table, what I'm getting. Let's move on to that. So here, what are the inputs I need to consider? That's very important thing. So just like our previous conversion, so what happened when come to exam, you people will confuse. So which one I need to consider and all. Carefully, you need to practice. If you practice, then easily you'll get the marks. So just see what are the inputs you need to consider. In the table, I'm going to use a QA, QB, QC. Then use a QA, QB, QC. Then easily you'll get the values. Just see, I'm going to write here it is JA. So why I'm going, okay, JA. I'm going to take on my inputs are QA, QB, and QC. Because QA, QB, QC are my present state. This present state only it is decide and how I'm going to connect it to my inputs. Okay. So QA, QB, QC, I'm going to take on here it is. Next, QB, QC means I'll get four combination. Just write the table. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, QA is nothing but two options you have. 0, 1. QB, QC means two options. I'll get 0, 0. 0, 1. 1, 1 and I'll get a 1, 0. Okay, now you just fill the values here. It is how to fill. I'm going to write for JA now. See, I'll take a JA. I'll take the value. It is 4 zeros. Four values. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 1. How I'm going to enter 0, 0, 0, 1. Next, remaining all it is XS. Just fill this one. X, X. X and X. Once you fill, you just tell me this solves KMF method and just tell me what is the equation of my J A. Just tell me the equation of J A. Directly, but there is no other option to me. I want to group these two only, right? Because I have only one. I can't group one separately. The x is there, then I'm going to consider it's an SOP form. I'm going to consider it's in 1. So I can group this. What is the value? 1, 1. QB and QC values are 1, 1. Directly I'm going to take and here it is QB dot QC. QC. Okay. So similarly, you try for K. K also, the inputs are same thing. QA, QB, QC. Just try and tell me the equation. Fill the values of xxxx and 01xx. This is QA. Next QB, QC. What is KA equation? This much of time you want. Directly you can tell, right? KA. QC? Yes. Just see here. Dual it is not possible. Okay, octa it is not possible. Then second you need to go for quad. Quad it is possible. Carefully you see that. You can group these four. You can group these four. If I group these four, the values row wise both the values are changing 0 to 1. Now what is option have 0 0 0 1. This is 1 1 and 1 0. The common term here it is 1 and 1. I have a QC. So KA is nothing but my QC. Okay. So in this way I can predict the values. Just see here it is JA is nothing but QB and QC and KA is nothing but QC. Is it clear about this one? How I got the J and K? Is it clear? Okay, now you try for JB and KB, same inputs. Just try for JB and KB. Take same inputs and just tell me and find out JC and KC. I'll give you 2 minutes of time. Be fast. JB is nothing but, okay, 1 minute. JB is equal to, I'll get Q. Okay, I'll take QA bar. Okay, next JC. Sorry, KB. QC. Okay, next JC cases. Yeah, both are it is 1. Everybody got this one? See, carefully you know that how to simplify that. Let's see whether it is correct or not. So I'm going to take and hit is JAK, we did this. And JBKB, what I'm going to do? Just enter these values. So JB, I'm going to enter 01XX and next it is 00XX. I'm going to take and here. So next 01XX and 00. And here don't do the quad. Quad it is not possible because there is no 1 here. You have a 0 only. Then only possible grouping of this one. If I do this one, row wise, it is not shared. Then I'm going to consider only one. I'll take a QA bar. Because of QA value 0, I'll take QA bar. Looking for a column wise, second term it is common term. That is QC. QC directly I'm going to take it here. QA bar dot QC. Similarly, KB, quad it is possible. Yes, you do that. And directly looking for common term QC is there. Directly you can take it out. And when come to last, JC and KC, you see that? So there is no zeros, directly you can write. In exam, as is all the shortcut methods. If there is no zero, means directly you can write JC value it is 1 and KC value it is 1. So directly after it is possible, just group and you can write. Hope you understand, right? How we are getting these values? Is it clear? So once it is clear, see, you got the values, JA, all the inputs you got. Then you can construct the circuit. That is our main intention. That is our intention. Directly you can, how to construct, carefully you see that, first you write the three flip-flop, this circuit already explained, you write the three flip-flop, JA, KA, QA, QA bar, JB, KB, QB, QB bar, JC, KC, QC, QC bar, you just write this, and I'm talking about synchronous counter, then synchronous means you take a clock signal, this is very, very important, this clock you need to connect, otherwise definitely lose your marks, so QC, sorry, clock I'm going to connect it to here, common clock I'm going to apply it. And next, you already predict the equations, right? Just you fill that equations. JA is nothing but QB, QC. Relation between QB and QC, you have an AND gate. I'm going to use AND gate, QB and QC. Okay, the output I'm going to connect it to here, it is JA. So you can see that JA. And KA, you see that connected to QC. Directly you write the variable, it is QC. QA bar and QC for this one because of JB. QA bar and QC and KB it is QC. And JC and KC, the values what I'm getting here is 1, 1. So because of 1, 1, directly connected to the logic 1 or you can connect it to VCC. Okay, so this is a design or circuit diagram of our mode 6 synchronous counter design using JK flip-flop. In this way also you can represent, but some of the books what they will do, they will connect these inputs also. This is optional to you. How? So you have a AND gate QB. Where is my QB? Yes, QB is there. This is connected to AND gate. Next QC, it is there. Okay, I'm going to connect it one line from here to here. If you want, you can connect. Not an issue. So K also it is connected to QC. You can just tap it to here. And this Q2 also it is connected, just tap it to here. And this QC also it is connected, just tap to here. And QA bar is there. Then you can short one line, one wire from here to here. You can connect. So in this way you can connect. Then what is my outputs you have? Output here QA. And next it is QB. And next it is QC. These are my outputs. What I am getting. These are my outputs. So it will, these outputs, if you connect it for LEDs or something, the output will start to count from 0 to 5. Is it clear about this one? Mode 6 counter? Anybody? Yeah, so very important. So